Hi guys, in this tutorial we are going to learn that how you can hide different slides through VBA as well as you can make colorful slides through VBA as well, colorful templates. But before that, make sure you have developer tab on top over here. If you don't have that, then what you have to do, you have to go in file and select options, click on customize ribbon, and here in main tabs you have to tick the developer option, click OK, and now your developer tab is showing over here. If you don't know VBA, I have another video in which I have shown that what exactly is VBA and how to assess that. So in the developer option, VBA is basically the Visual Basic. You have to click on that. And now if we want to create colorful slides, then we are going to use the help of ChatGPT. And what you have to do, first you have to insert a module. And here you have to paste a code. So what if I'm not a developer, I don't know how to paste a code over here, but still I want to make colorful slides. As a layman, you can also do that. To do that, you have to go to ChatGPT. So I'm using ChatGPT 3.5. You don't need to use ChatGPT 4 for that. Just paste, I need some code which shows colorful templates. You just mentioned VBA code. And so ChatGPT is going to give you a code for the templates. If this code is with errors, we are going to paste this code on our VBA to check if it's working. So now we are going to run this. So this one shows error. So what we have to do, go back and type, it shows error. Now it's going to give you a proper code. If that code is showing error, then we have to ask the software again. Now control A and delete. And now paste the new code and we are going to run it again. Now this one also shows error. So in order to make ChatGPT to work properly for you, you have to give him suggestion as well that this code is giving you error and it's going to give you another code which you can use. So now I'm going to paste this one again, and this time same run. So I'm going to run it, and this time it says object doesn't support this method or property. I'm going to click on debug to see which one. Okay, this one I'm going to remove it. If it's not working, just simply remove it and run it again, and this time no errors. So let me see what it shows. So as you can see, these are the slides which are created through this code. But what if you want to hide any of these slides? Suppose if you don't want slide in between, like 4 and 5. So what you can do, go out same developer options. And this time you have to create a new module. And in that new module, you have to paste another code. So now I'm back on ChatGPT and you have to type, okay, tell me how to hide slides through VBA. So it gives you this code. You have to copy this one. If it doesn't work, you have to come back again and then ask again. Let me see this one first, if it works, and then run it. No, this one is not working. Go back to ChatGPT again. So now whatever error it says, you have to mention, it says method or data member not found. So it's going to suggest you another code according to that error. Copy that, and this time again we are going to paste it, run it, and this one works. Okay, so these slides are hidden. So in order to unhide some slides to show in the slideshow, you just click on that and unhide it. You can use this shortcut key to hide as well, but I'm just telling you that how you can do this through a developer option. If you have a lot of slides and you just don't want to do it manually like this and just want to show few 2 or 3 slides, then this is a method which you can adopt. And if you click on slideshow, it's only going to show you slide 1 and 2. That's it, because rest of the slides, they are all hidden. What if you want to show slide 6, slide 9? And now we are going to click on the slideshow. So this is the one to 6 and 9. So this is how you can use VBA to make your slides colorful, different presentations, and also hide and unhide. If you have very long projects and every time you want to use the same settings, then you can do that. If you want to know anything about VBA security and the macro security, I've explained in my previous video, you can go watch that. And thanks for watching. I hope you like this video. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you.